Imagine walking into your doctor's office, heart pounding, as they draw a small vial of blood, not because you feel sick, but as part of a routine screening. The result? A number called PSA. Suddenly, that seemingly innocuous little acronym packs the weight of fear, hope, and uncertainty. Welcome to the world of the PSA, prostate-specific antigen test, a tool that can hint at prostate cancer, but also throws up false alarms more often than you might think. In 2025, understanding your PSA is more complicated and more important than ever. With evolving research, age-specific reference ranges, and a growing conversation about overdiagnosis, navigating the PSA test requires knowledge, context, and a little bit of humor, because men, if you're worried about your PSA, we promise it's not because it's judging you, it's just doing its job. Today on Nourish Today, let's dive deep into what a PSA test really is, what normal means at different ages, why higher PSA doesn't always equal cancer, and what you can do in terms of preventive health and mental resilience around prostate screening. The prostate-specific antigen PSA test continues to be one of the most debated, misunderstood, and heavily analyzed medical screenings in modern men's health. By 2025, the test has not fundamentally changed in its biological purpose. It still measures the level of PSA, a protein produced by the prostate, but the interpretation of that number has evolved significantly. Even among urologists in major academic institutions, there is ongoing discussion about how much weight a single PSA result should carry, and how much of a role age, genetics, inflammation, and lifestyle factors should play in shaping a patient's management plan. To understand PSA properly, one must peel back the layers of nuance. Because PSA is not like a cholesterol number that most Americans immediately know how to interpret, it's not like blood sugar, where the categories of normal, pre-diabetic, and diabetic are straightforward. PSA exists in a gray zone, a measurement that can be influenced by cancer, but also influenced by a weekend bike ride, a heavy workout, a prostate infection, a high-stress week, or even something as simple as ejaculation shortly before testing. This complexity is exactly why age-specific PSA interpretation matters so much in 2025. Urology specialists at institutions like Mayo Clinic, Harvard Health, and Cleveland Clinic consistently emphasize that PSA is not a one-number-fits-all type of screening. A PSA of 3 may be concerning for a 4- or 5-year-old, but may be entirely acceptable for a 7- or 0-year-old. Conversely, a PSA that looks normal on paper may still be associated with cancer, especially if the PSA is rising quickly over time. Understanding PSA in a 2025 clinical context, in the most basic sense, PSA is a protein. The prostate secretes it naturally to help liquefy semen, and a small amount always escapes into the bloodstream. When the prostate enlarges, gets inflamed, or develops cancerous cells, PSA levels may increase. Medical school textbooks often explain this relationship in simple terms: more prostate activity equals more PSA, but in practice, the correlation is much messier. Cancerous prostates do not always produce high PSA, while benign prostates sometimes produce excessively high PSA. Men with extremely aggressive tumors may show only modest elevations, while men with large benign prostates may have PSA levels that constantly hover above the normal range. To make things even more complicated, PSA changes over time. A man could have a PSA of 1.5 one year, 2.1 the next, and 1.8 the year after that, even if nothing abnormal is happening. PSA levels fluctuate naturally, similar to how cortisol levels rise and fall depending on stress, sleep, or the time of day. That is why major medical centers encourage trend-based interpretation, sometimes referred to as PSA velocity, how fast PSA rises, PSA doubling time, how quickly PSA numbers double, PSA density, PSA level divided by prostate volume, age-adjusted PSA, normal ranges, free versus total PSA ratios, advanced biomarkers like P2 PSA or the Prostate Health Index, PHI. In other words, PSA in 2025 is no longer seen as a standalone tool. It is seen as the beginning of a conversation, not the end of it. Normal PSA ranges by age in 2025. Clinical organizations vary slightly in their reference ranges, but the most commonly cited data from Mayo Clinic and Cleveland Clinic provide these benchmarks for PSA considered within normal limits for men with no known prostate disease. Under 40 is less than or equal to 2 ng/mL. Age 40-49 is less than or equal to 2.5 ng/mL. Age 50-59 is less than or equal to 3.5 ng/mL. Age 60-69 is less than or equal to 4.5 ng/mL. Age 70-79 is less than or equal to 6.5 ng/mL. Age 80 plus, up to 7.2 ng, ml may still be normal, depending on prostate size. These ranges are not strict rules, but evidence-based guidelines derived from population studies. Urologists emphasize that the larger the prostate becomes with age due to benign prostatic hyperplasia, or BPH, the more PSA it will naturally produce. A healthy example is someone like Warren Buffett, who is widely known for maintaining his medical checkups into his 90 seconds. If a man of Buffett's age had a PSA of 6 or even 7, it would not automatically trigger panic among doctors, especially if the number had been stable for years. But if a 4 or 5-year-old entrepreneur with the intensity of Elon Musk suddenly had a PSA of 4.5, even if he felt perfectly fine, the situation would prompt a deeper evaluation because that number is high for his age bracket. Age contextualizes PSA. Without that context, the number is nearly meaningless. Why younger men should not ignore PSA. Although prostate cancer is much more common after age 50, younger men, especially those with a strong family history, are increasingly being screened in 2025. Men in their 40s with fathers or brothers diagnosed with prostate cancer, particularly those who were diagnosed under age 60, face substantially higher lifetime risk. In addition, certain genetic markers such as BRCA1 and BRCA2, widely known in breast cancer research, significantly increase prostate cancer risk in men. Public figures like King Charles III, who openly shared his experience with prostate enlargement, helped encourage more young men to take prostate health seriously, even though his case was benign. A typical man in his 40s should have a PSA below 2.5. But doctors worry more about rapid increases than about the absolute number. For example, if PSA rises from 1 to 2.4 inches 1 year, that's concerning. If PSA rises from 1 to 1.4, that might be trivial. Imagine if someone with a leadership profile like Tim Cook, healthy, disciplined, and consistent, showed a PSA rise that exceeded these expected trends. Doctors would immediately investigate because the change, not the number, suggests something biologically significant is happening. Younger men should not expect prostate cancer, but they also should not ignore PSA trends, especially if they have risk factors. The most common non-cancer causes of high PSA. One reason that PSA interpretation is so difficult is that PSA rises for many benign reasons. In fact, urologists often see PSA elevations due to everyday lifestyle factors or completely unrelated medical conditions. 1. Benign prostate enlargement, BPH. By age 60, more than half of men have BPH. By age 80, over 80% do. The enlarged prostate secretes more PSA simply because it is larger. This is one of the most common explanations for PSA readings of 4-6 ng/mL in older men. Think of someone like Joe Biden, who is in his 80s. If an 80-year-old man of his age has a PSA of 6, urologists would not consider that unusual. It may be appropriate for age-related prostate growth. 2. Prostatitis, inflammation or infection. Acute or chronic inflammation dramatically elevates PSA. Some men with prostatitis see their PSA jump from 2 to 10 or even higher. This can mimic the appearance of cancer and cause intense anxiety. But once treatment is completed, PSA often returns to baseline. 3. Recent ejaculation. PSA can rise 10-20% for up to 48 hours after ejaculation. Men are typically advised to abstain for at least 2 days before a PSA test to avoid false elevation. 4. Vigorous exercise or cycling. Activities that put pressure on the prostate can temporarily raise PSA. Long-distance cyclists often show elevated results immediately after training. 5. Medical procedures. Catheterization, prostate massage, cystoscopy, prostate biopsy. All of these can elevate PSA significantly. 6. Age-related variability. Even without disease, PSA naturally climbs as men age. A 70-year-old man may have PSA levels 2 or 3 times higher than his levels in his 50s, without any underlying pathology. PSA velocity. Why the trend matters more than the number. In 2025, PSA velocity, how quickly PSA increases over time, has become more important than ever. A single PSA reading is like looking at a single stock price. You don't know what it means until you see the chart behind it. If Warren Buffett looked only at a single snapshot of the stock market, he would have lost billions. Similarly, looking at a single PSA number without comparing it to past values is medically incomplete. Typical red flag velocity patterns include a PSA increase of more than 0.75 ng/mL per year, a PSA doubling time under 3 years, a PSA that rises steadily for 3 or more tests. This is analogous to watching the economic indicators of a country. If inflation, debt, and unemployment sharply rise at the same time, Economists become concerned even if the absolute numbers are not catastrophic yet. Rapid upward change signals underlying instability. In prostate health, rapid PSA increase suggests biological activity, sometimes inflammation, sometimes benign growth, and sometimes cancer. Doctors pay attention to the pattern. PSA density and why prostate size changes interpretation. PSA density is calculated by dividing PSA level by prostate volume measured from imaging. For example, a PSA of 6 inches, a prostate that is 100 grams, very large, may be completely benign. A PSA of 4 inches, a prostate that is 20 grams, very small, is much more concerning. The prostate's size dictates how much PSA it produces. This is why older men, like Bill Gates or Xi Jinping, both in age ranges where BPH is statistically common, could have PSA levels above 4 without it meaning anything dangerous. Free PSA, another layer of interpretation. PSA circulates in the blood in two forms. Bound PSA, attached to proteins. Free PSA, not attached. Cancer tends to reduce the percentage of free PSA. The lower the free to total PSA ratio, the higher the risk of cancer. Typical interpretations. Free PSA is less than 10% high risk. Free PSA, 10-25% intermediate risk. Free PSA is greater than 25% low risk. This is not definitive, but significantly enhances accuracy. For instance, if a political leader like Emmanuel Macron, who is relatively young at 47, suddenly had a PSA of 4.2, doctors would immediately check free PSA to avoid jumping into a biopsy prematurely.
The Prostate Health Index, PHI, 2025's more accurate biomarker PHI combines total PSA-free PSA P2 PSA, a more cancer-specific form of PSA. The result is a single score that better predicts clinically significant prostate cancer. Many urologists in major U.S. centers now consider PHI the most reliable non-invasive screening tool when PSA is in the gray zone of 2.5 to 10 nanograms per milliliter. PHI reduces unnecessary biopsies, which is crucial because biopsies carry risks like infection or bleeding. The reality of PSA false alarms. PSA anxiety is so common in the U.S. that psychologists have coined informal terms like PSA panic mode. Men often fear the worst when they see a number above 4.0, even though most elevations are benign. High PSA does not equal cancer. Low PSA does not guarantee no cancer. This dual uncertainty is why PSA is sometimes compared to geopolitical intelligence reports. Leaders often receive warnings that may or may not indicate real threats. Making decisions requires context, experience, and sometimes waiting for additional data. A single PSA reading is like an ambiguous intelligence briefing. It tells you something is happening, but not exactly what. When biopsies are truly necessary, by 2025, doctors are increasingly selective about recommending biopsies. The old rule, biopsy anyone with PSA above 4.0, is no longer considered appropriate. Instead, biopsies are recommended when multiple indicators align. Persistently elevated PSA, abnormal PSA velocity, low free PSA percentages, suspicious PHI scores, family history of aggressive prostate cancer, concerning MRI findings, abnormal digital rectal exam, modern MR. Eye technology has also reduced unnecessary biopsies by identifying which lesions are suspicious enough to justify sampling. High-profile figures who prioritize advanced medical screening, such as Jeff Bezos or Mohammed bin Salman, MBS, often undergo MRI before biopsy, reflecting the global shift toward precision medicine. Lifestyle factors that influence PSA and prostate health. Scientific research continues to emphasize that lifestyle plays a meaningful, though not absolute, role in prostate health. Diet foods associated with prostate benefits include tomatoes, high in lycopene, broccoli, and other cruciferous vegetables, omega-3 rich fish, nuts and seeds, green tea. Diets high in processed meats or saturated fats are associated with worse prostate outcomes. If someone like Barack Obama, known for his disciplined lifestyle, followed a clean diet for heart and prostate health, it would match the recommendations given to millions of men worldwide. Exercise moderate aerobic activity benefits prostate health and reduces inflammation. However, high-intensity cycling can temporarily elevate PSA. Stress, chronic stress affects hormonal balance and inflammation, which can influence PSA trends. World leaders frequently undergo regular medical evaluation because the chronic stress of leadership is known to exacerbate inflammatory markers. Sexual activity. Frequent ejaculation shortly before testing may cause temporary PSA elevation. How doctors counsel patients in 2025. When a patient receives a PSA result, doctors typically take a stepwise approach. Repeat the test if the elevation is borderline, check free PSA and PHI if still elevated, evaluate family history and genetic risk. Order MRI when uncertainty remains, recommend biopsy only when justified. This structured approach mirrors how advisors guide people in high-stakes roles. Just like a head of state must consider multiple data sources before making a decision, urologists examine PSA results from every angle before recommending something as serious as a biopsy. Real-world example scenarios using well-known figures. Example 1. A man like Elon Musk, age 53 in 2025, gets a PSA of 3.8. This number is elevated for his age. If last year it was 2.1, PSA velocity is concerning. He would likely undergo free PSA evaluation and PHI. If PHI is high, an MRI would follow. Example 2. A man like Warren Buffett, age 94, has a PSA of 7.0, normal for age-related prostate enlargement. If stable from previous years, no immediate concern. Example 3. A man like King Charles III, who openly discussed prostate issues, shows a PSA of 5.0 at age 76. Could be BPH or age-related enlargement. Given his medical transparency and routine care, doctors would monitor, not panic. Example 4. A 48-year-old world leader like Justin Trudeau gets a PSA of 4.4. Too high for age. Requires full evaluation, repeat testing, velocity assessment, PHI, MRI, the future of PSA interpretation. Beyond 2025, researchers are continually refining biomarkers to improve prostate cancer detection. The biggest goals include reducing unnecessary biopsies, identifying aggressive cancers early, differentiating dangerous versus harmless tumors, using artificial intelligence to read MR, eye scans more accurately. Many predict that PSA alone will eventually become a secondary metric behind advanced molecular tests. In 2025, the PSA test remains a valuable but imperfect tool. There's no one-size-fits-all normal PSA, age, health status, family history, and test context all matter. While it can offer an early warning, a PSA result doesn't always mean cancer, nor does a low PSA mean you're in the clear. Here's what matters most. Understand the age-adjusted normal PSA range, and don't treat 4.0 nanograms per milliliter as a rigid cutoff. Use advanced tools, free PSA, PHI, PSA velocity when appropriate. Make screening decisions in partnership with your doctor, weighing benefits and risks. Support your prostate health through nutrition, exercise, stress management, and regular medical conversations. And finally, because we like to end on a lighter note, if your PSA comes back high, remember, it's not a reflection of you, just a biological signal. It's like your prostate's way of screaming, "Hey boss, just checking in." Approach it with curiosity, not fear. If you found this helpful, don't forget to subscribe to Nourish Today for more science-backed health deep dives. Because caring for your body shouldn't be rocket science. It should be nourishment.